sea scorpion, one of the most grotesque of predators. And look at that, look at the tail curling. That's how they get their name, but there's no venom in there, like their namesakes on the land. And you've got to be careful, are those formidable pincers at the front? Oh.
The scorpion gave me a graphic demonstration of just how formidable its claws are. It literally shredded the bait at my feet before moving on to bigger prey. Ah!
This is intriguing. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why they're all gathering, but first there was one sea scorpion, then there was another, then another, then another. And now they are all around me. There's a whole carpet of them moving along the seafloor. They're whizzing past my head. They're all heading in one direction. There's the orca cone. And it spotted one of the sea scorpions. This is what they were doing. I saw them moving in the shallows, moving towards the shore, and this is a mass spawning. It's a full moon at the moment. This is the highest tide, and they're laying their eggs in the sand. The eggs will be protected. And when the next high tide comes in about a month or so, the young larvae will hatch and be taken back out to sea. And some of these sea scorpions, they're gonna stay around here until the eggs hatch. Fossils have been found with baby sea scorpions inside the stomachs of the big ones, and that's what they do. They wait around here and feed on the babies as they hatch on the next high tide.
Or division, then, isn't exactly a picnic. Anywhere the air gives you a headache and you can't go swimming without a chainmail suit probably isn't going to take off as a holiday destination. But prehistory has worse still to offer. The next deadly sea is the Triassic.